To hell with your dreams and aspirations. Do what you're told to, behave the way you're expected to, and don't ask these silly questions, you nuisance. Just go with the flow, follow the crowd, blend in, and everything is gonna be just okay. How often have you guys heard people around you say something like that? Don't forget to put your answers in your comments below. Certainly, most of us do know what it sometimes takes to persevere in following our dreams. True that, we may have been born into different cultures and different traditions, and from the moment of our birth onwards we've been instilled with different sets of values and different priorities in life, and yet we've all got one thing in common. We're all human beings who are geared to dream. Politicians all over the world are waging their wars for money and clout and keep sending ordinary but brainwashed citizens to fight each other and die for their interests. Moreover, they make sure we fear and despise each other, because fear and loathing has literally become a staple of domestic policies on a global scale. So what? Politicians are really capable of turning altogether decent people into mindless and merciless fanatics, dangerous puppets in their hands who've given up on their own dreams, and make sure that everyone else abandons their dreams too. We are programmed to hate each other, and with the spread of internet and social networking, we even got a special word for it: haters. The longer I live, folks, the more convinced I get that most people around us are certified haters and dream killers. Indeed, xenophobia, violent nationalism, racism, homophobia, sexism, I'm sorry, speciesism are rampant in today's world, and these are all different manifestations of fear and loathing, of this hatred with which we are all being instilled on a daily basis. I used to be a hardcore dreamer. As a kid, I dreamt of becoming a professional speaker and a teacher. But I had a problem, a speech impairment, in fact, a scientist call it. I was stammering. And I believe you should know the backdrop against which I was raised. It was a small single industry town in Russia's heartland where thugs and xenophobic and aggressive, violent hoodlums were everywhere. And you know, they would go after, attack, abuse, beat up severely anyone who strived to think, look or act differently. And I did think, look and act differently. And to top it all off, I was a stammerer, which effectively made me an easy target for them. The point is, I had lots of things to say, always scores of well-founded opinions to articulate, objections to make, concerns to voice, but I couldn't do it. You know, at a point where it would have been, like, most timely to share, my voice would crackle, words barely slipping my mouth, and I'd go speechless. Not figuratively speechless, literally speechless. I just couldn't pronounce a single word. And that really hurt, and that was an obvious obstacle and a hurdle to fulfilling my dream. Now, have you guys ever run into a situation where a blazing thought or a witty comment or a, you know, poignant remark occurred to you during the conversation, but you somehow failed to utter it in time, and later you regretted it? Have you ever experienced a feeling like that? If so, you must know what it was like to me, what I felt routinely on a daily basis. To make matters even uglier though, I was being bullied for that. Bullied by whom, you'd ask? Well, schoolmates, peers, teachers. Imagine that for a second, being bullied by teachers. And I was, and back then I was a small kid. And that really, really hurt. And that was an obvious hurdle to fulfilling my dream. Now, I'm sure most of you sometimes feel embarrassed for someone else, don't you? And I bet you, had you turned up from a school leaving ceremony in 2005, you would definitely have blushed for me. You know, I was slated to recite a poem there. But what a poem it was! It was a fucking bluster of a poem. If by Rudyard Kipling. You can check it out on the internet if you're somehow unfamiliar with it. The whole message of that poem is that of braving the storm of human disbelief, ridicule, mockery, bullying, and libel, weathering the rough and tumble of social situations, and keeping cool, staying focused on your goals, staying true to your personality and your dream, and not giving in to social pressures. And that inspired me. I was resolute to give a hell of a rendition. So I went on stage and stumbled my way through the poem. I was embarrassed. But it was then that I made up my mind to work hard on that. I was determined to improve my speech. And I adhered most tenaciously to my long-cherished dream. I started deliberately putting myself into most stressful situations where I had to drive my point home, come hell or high water. And little by little, my speech was improving. And although psychologists and doctors' efforts were firing blanks, I began to figure it out on my own. And it started to pay off. I began to succeed in fulfilling my dream. You see, back then, I was a small, shy, self-conscious, glossophobic and overall sociophobic kid who dreaded even a remote possibility of engaging in a conversation, let alone speaking in public. And now, I'm giving public lectures and live interviews, interpreting in business negotiations and teaching workshops on business communication, serving as a voice actor and narrating documentaries. I kept following my dream and I succeeded. And so can you. So my message is persevere, guys. Persevere in pursuing your dreams. Stay focused on your goals. Come hell or high water, don't give in to social pressures, and you will succeed. Thanks for being with me. Don't forget to put your comments below and to share your stories. Subscribe to my channel. Enjoy your day.